Hello everyone and welcome back. In the previous video, we did an overview of the project as a whole and took a look at the end result. In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can create our brand new project and get our hands on the FBX assets that we will be using for the purposes of this video series. So with that, first thing that we have here is the Unreal Project Browser. So from the Unreal Launcher, I've clicked Launch, and now we are on the Unreal Project Browser. And it's going to default to the Projects tab. We only have one project here. Any projects that you have created will essentially be listed under My Projects. If you haven't created any projects, this may be empty. But we only have one project, which was the end result of this series. So I'm going to hop over to the New Project tab because we're going to start from scratch here. And on this tab, we're going to use a blank project. So we're going to start with a clean, empty project with no code. We also want to make sure that starter content is enabled. It should be enabled by default. If it is not, you can click on the icon here and then choose with starter content. That'll give us some assets to play with if we wanted to start prototyping out a level with our playable character here. It'll give us some textures, some materials, some static meshes, some things to kind of play with in our level. So we want to make sure that that is enabled. Then I'm going to choose a save location for the project. And then give your project a name. I'm going to name mine something better than My Project. Just going to call it Third Person Project. That's a little bit more descriptive. And then I'm going to hit Create Project. Now, that's going to take a second to load up our newly created project. And while it's doing that, I'm going to pop open a web browser here. I want to show you where you can get your hands on those FBX assets. Now, the link to this page should be in the description of this video. If it is not, you can go to wiki.unrealengine.com/file:third_person_fbx.zip. And that should bring you to this page where you can right click and save this file here. This is going to have all the assets that we need for this video series. So let me pop that up and show you what's in there really quickly. So here are all the FBX assets that we are going to import. These assets were actually taken from existing projects. So the third person template project includes a third person idle, person jump. All of these animations here are included in that template, as well as the skeletal mesh, which is the SK mannequin asset here. And then these montage punch examples, these were taken from the content examples project. I believe it's the animation map. With the Owen character. We just wanted to place these in a place where you could easily access them and download them. We could have gone through the process of migrating them over, but I figured this would be easier. And then this will also show the FBX import process as well. So now that we have all of these, let's pop our project back up here. So here is our project. I did actually want to pause here. This is actually going to be a short video. Because in the next video, we will go through the actual import process. But there's some things that I wanted to touch on in terms of skeletal assets and things to look out for when you import your FBX file. So we're going to break here. And in the next video, we will go through the import process together and start importing those FBX assets. Thank you so much, and we'll see you in the next video.